Okay, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to evaluate this kind of trig expressions at different angles without using a calculator and also without using a unit circle. But you do have to know the 30, 60, 90 special right triangle and also the 45, 45, 90 special right triangle. With that in mind, let's get started with number one, sine of 120 degrees. I will be using the reference triangle method. Let's go ahead and draw the x and y axis. The 120 degrees is positive, so that means we start by looking at the positive x-axis all the time, and then because that's positive, we are going to rotate in a counterclockwise fashion, so go like this. So we are going to rotate 120 degrees. So you see, this is 90 degrees already. We have to go 30 more, so it's about like there, right? So keep in mind that's 30 degrees. So I'm going to stop right there, and then I'm going to draw from the origin, touch that, and then draw a line like that. Okay? That's called a terminal side. And we have to figure this out. And that angle right here is precisely, that's 30, so this will be 60. So this is 60 degrees. And then we're going to form the reference triangle. And to do so, you always go straight up and down. In this case, it will be down. Yeah. So this is the reference triangle. Now, we have a 60, 90, of course, that will be 30. What's the ratio of the sides of a 30, 60, 90 special right triangle? The answer is that the shortest side is 1, and the longer side is square root of 3, and the hypotenuse, which is going to be 2. But here's the catch, though. Notice that this one is to the left. It has a negative x value, so it's technically negative 1, right? And with this picture, we can go ahead and look at sine of 120 degrees as what? By looking at this triangle, this angle here, it's just opposite over hypotenuse, which is just square root of 3 over 2, and then we are done. Just like that. We can practice more because use this picture. We can also do cosine of 120 degrees. Cosine is what? By looking at this reference angle, all right, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so it's negative 1 over 2, so that's all we have, and that's it. And let's also do tangent, might as well. Tangent of 120 degrees, again, look at this reference angle, tangent is opposite over adjacent, technically y value over x value, but just square root of 3 over negative 1, simplify that, it's just negative square root of 3, so that will be tangent 120 degrees. All right, let's try this. We have cosine of negative 45 degrees. So here, again, I'm just going to draw our reference triangle picture. Negative angle means we go clockwise. So we will just have to draw something like this. This is negative 45 degrees. And then I will draw the terminal side. So it's like this. And in fact, this angle is just, I can look at this reference angle as 45. I don't want to be too technical, but like the reference angle is always positive and it's always in between of 0 and 90 degrees. But when you have to do this, it's always nice numbers. So you don't have to write down negative 45. Just keep it like that. And in this case, we have a 45, 45, 90 special right triangle, and the ratio of the sides is 1, 1 square root of 2. But this one is down. It has negative y value, so technically this is negative 1, all right? And now let's look for sine of negative 45, which is really this angle here that I put down in red. And I mean cosine. Cosine is what? Adjacent over hypotenuse, so 1 over square root of 2, like this. And if your teacher does not want the radical on the bottom, you can just go ahead multiply the top and bottom by square root of 2. So in another word, we just get square root of 2 over 2. That's fine. Well, in calculus data, you can just leave the answer like that, and that's pretty much it. Of course, you can also practice with sine. Actually, let's try, why don't we do cosecant here? Cosecant of negative 45 degrees. How do we do cosecant? Hypotenuse over opposite. hypotenuse over opposite. So square root of 2 over negative 1, which is just negative square root of 2. And let's do secant. Secant negative 45 degrees. Secant is hypotenuse over adjacent. So it's just square root of 2 over 1, which is just square root of 2. It's just the reciprocal of that. And then that's pretty much it. And let's also do cotangent because we haven't done cotangent yet. Cotangent negative 45 degrees. Cotangent is adjacent over opposite. So 1 over negative 1. And that will give us negative 1. Just like that. And just like that. All right, let's try this one. Tangent of pi over 6. In my opinion, it's always easier to work with degrees. So let's take some time to change the radian to degrees. And to do so, look, pi over 6, we multiply that by 180 over pi. Pi and pi cancel. Reduce 6 and 180, we get 30 degrees. So really, we're talking about 30 degrees, right? So this right here is just the same as tangent of 30 degrees. And then let's take a look at a reference triangle. 30 degrees positive is just a little bit like this. And then draw the terminal side and then go straight down this time. That's the reference triangle. And this is just 30 degrees. That's the right angle. 30 degrees, this right here, the shortest side has ratio 1, longer side, square root of 3, and then hypotenuse 2, right? So make sure you remember this 2 special triangle. Don't worry about my picture, maybe it's not the best. All right, let's figure this out. Tangent of 30 degrees will be what? Tangent is opposite over adjacent. So 1 over square root of 3. Multiply square root of 3, multiply by square root of 3. And we'll see that it's going to be square root of 3 over 3. Yeah, just like that, tangent of 30 degrees. All right, so that's pretty much it. But before we go, I'm going to give you guys some questions for you guys to try. All right, so this right here, go ahead. You are going to try that and let me know what you guys get. So this is number 4. Go ahead and try to figure out what's secant of 210 degrees. And then number 5, go ahead and figure out what's tangent of 135 degrees. And then number 6, go ahead and figure out what's, let's do cosecant of, let's say 120 degrees. Okay, so leave the answer in the comment and let me know. That's it.